Good morning. For prophets. Sunday for prophets. May 9, 2022. For prophets are praying in America, Philadelphia, in Wednesday afternoon, 4 p.m. in May 11, 2020. I see shooting in the praying Jerusalem.
But first tonight, a gunman opens fire on a group painting a mural, leaving a 20-year-old man dead and three others injured. I'm Yuki Washington.
And I'm Jessica Cartaglia. That shooting happened around 4 this afternoon on the 5500 block of King Sessing Avenue in southwest Philadelphia. Eyewitness News reporter Alicia Roberts is live at police headquarters with the search for a very brazen gunman. Alicia.
Very dangerous, very brazen, Jessica. Those are the words used tonight by Philadelphia police. They are searching for that shooter who walked up to a crowd armed with a semi-automatic weapon and started shooting. He did so at the same place another young man's life was tragically cut short last year.
You're like, bang, 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 bang.
It happened in broad daylight.
And she called me and she's like, Mom, I think they're shooting again.
This mother rushing home to make sure her daughter was okay. Just outside her front door and across the street from a middle school, a scary but all too familiar scene.
Less than 6 months ago, another guy got killed right there. Nice guy. Still don't know why.
There were about 8 to 10 people standing on the corner where there was a memorial for a male that was killed sometime last year.
A memorial to mark a friend shot and killed last fall.
They were also painting the side of a market.
Now the place of another violent tragedy.
The shooter walked up and from very close range began firing shots into the crowd.
Police say the gunman fired 10 shots, hitting 4 people, killing one man.
A 20-year-old male who was shot multiple times throughout his chest and torso and hip area was pronounced dead.
The three others are being treated at Presbyterian Hospital. Two men are listed in stable condition. The other, hit multiple times in the chest, is in critical condition.
We're getting information that someone did return fire.
Police say 5 shots were fired back. It's not clear if either shooter was hit. And within the last 30 minutes, Philadelphia police tell me they are continuing to review surveillance video of the incident, working to produce 2 pictures of those 2 shooters, but they are asking for your help. Anyone with information is urged to give them a call. Reporting live outside police headquarters, Alicia Roberts, CBS 3 Eyewitness News.
Alicia, thank you.